because it is actually a combination of the first and the second verse. And more importantly, here this entropy term is involved, which is normally said that it is not understandable. You must have gone through Castellan's book, but there is a chapter that starts with a very readable passage. It echoes in classrooms, what is entropy and so on. So naturally in a thermodynamics class, we should talk a bit more about entropy. So I am starting that one. Now suppose there are three spheres. This is called rigid spheres. Metal. And it has a specific heat equal to S. This is a problem. It has a mass M1, it has a mass M2. This one is there at a temperature T1, then T2. Now we take the same thing. But then it connects them by a conduction square. So there will be a heat flow. There will be a heat flow. So naturally, the heat flow will continue till equilibrium means they will come, they will attain a common temperature. Isn't it? Fine. So how do you calculate the entropy change? So we are interested in calculating the entropy change. Delta S equal to how much? So some of you should be able to do it. So please do and tell me. So, the first hint is this, that the first year students are not,
all the semesters.
So they are there also.
First year, second year, third year.
But I shouldn't expect answers from first year for this. But from second year, yes. Or from third year?
Both.
So you see that rigid spheres. Now since the spheres are rigid, so you can take this term equal to zero. So that simplifies the problem a lot. Isn't it? Now you have doubts. Any doubt with anybody? What is DU? DU is?
Yes.
have doubts with this religion also. No, you may have. There is no problem. One should have doubts. Didozio once said that doubt everything. So, whenever there is any air of doubt, you must clarify it. Either with your fellow colleagues or with teachers or this time with me. So is that relation all right?
Very simple problem, so you should be able to. How to get tea?